Hello, I'm Zhiting. I wanted to be there to give you a presentation of PLCrypto or Symmetric Cryptographic Library for Programmable Logic Controllers. A Programmable Logic Controller PLC is an industrial computer that has been widely used for the control of manufacturing processes, such as assembly lines, machines, robotic devices, or any activity that requires high reliability. Ease of programming and process fault diagnosis. With the development of industrial Internet of Things, the industrial control systems are connected to the Internet. So, many PLCs have therefore become the primary targets of attackers to compromise. However, the commercial PLCs may lack proper security functions, like encryption and authentication. For example, suppose attackers are somehow connected to the operational technology network. In that case, they can easily intercept and manipulate the communication between PLCs and SCADA. So, the attackers can simply send malicious command to the PLC to sabotage the physical processes. A common way to enhance the security of PLC is to use the cryptographic algorithms to protect the communication and data. To do so, it is possible to modify the firmware to implement the cryptographic algorithms. But the firmware is closed source, so this approach cannot be done by the third party. We can also buy the secure module from the manufacturer. However, it might be very expensive, or it may be not supported by some legacy PLCs. In this work, we are motivated to implement the cryptographic algorithms based on the logic control plane of PLC itself, using the standard program language structured text, which is free to use and easy to program like other high-level programming language. To the best of our knowledge, PLCrypto is the first ST-based cryptographic library that is executable on commercial PLCs. In PLCrypto, we implemented a wide range of symmetric cryptographic schemes, which provide the most desirable security properties and functionalities. Confidentiality, integrity, and pseudo-randomness. We also realized a protocol called Proof of Aliveness as a case study to show how to use the implemented cryptographic algorithms. What are the challenges on securely and efficiently implementing PLCrypto? I'm going to introduce the answers of this research question. The first challenge we meet here is the programming language. The structured text consists of a series of instructions. As in high-level languages, like if then else, or loops while do. But it only supports few data types, as listed in the table. Our experimental platform, the unbridled PLC, does not support the unsigned integer. Also, it does not have shift rotated operations. And low instructions can access memory addresses like say. Those limitations of ST increase the difficulty of the implementation. However, the ST also has some advantages that we could leverage. It can directly access each bit of an int variable. Later, I will show such bitwise operation can be used to optimize the implementation. The second challenge is caused by the remote monitoring capability of PLC. PLC allows one to accurately monitor things in a real-time manner, even when it is running.
The administrator can read and write tags and modify the programs. The modification of a program can be easily prevented by switching the PLC to a run mode. The main challenge here is how to securely deal with the tag monitor, which should be carefully studied.
We formally call the tag manipulation capabilities of the adversary as tag manipulation attacks. The TMAs are unique on PLC, and the TMAs would jeopardize not only the confidentiality but also the integrity of critical tag views. For example, if we store a cryptographic key in a tag, then it might be obtained by the attackers to trivially break the corresponding cryptographic scheme. So, one of the major goals in the implementation of PLCrypto is to prevent the TMA. We assume that low extra trusted hardware is used to store the cryptographic securities for PLC, since we want to propose the low-cost solution. Next, I'm going to show how to prevent TMA. Before that, let's first review an important notion of PLC, the scan cycle. Scan cycle is a cycle in which the PLC gathers the inputs, runs the PLC program sequentially, and then updates the outputs. So, PLC operate by continually scanning programs and repeat this process many times. The PLC program can run different types of tasks, such as continuous, event, or periodic. We note that the event and periodic tasks cannot be interrupted by the communication tasks. So, in a periodic task, low rate write operations can be done within a scan cycle. However, the adversary can still read and write tags between two scan cycles. So, our countermeasure for this is to design hard coding techniques in our implementation. Basically, we can use kinds of hard coding strategies. The first one is hard coding with runtime loading. Why we need this one? Because if we load the tag views once and use them across multiple scan cycles, then the adversary can read them at the end of each scan cycle. In our first hard coding strategy, an algorithm must load the concrete views of critical tags on the fly at the beginning of each scan cycle. We can assume a tag with the concrete view there. At the end of the execution, the algorithm should erase the tag to be zero. In this way, the adversary can only read zero views. However, the first strategy is not efficient if the number of tags is huge. This approach may become a performance bottleneck of the implementation. For example, there can be over 2,000 assignments in the implementation of a subset sum based one-way function. So, we propose another hard coding strategy to hard code a tag view at where it is used. For an encryption, Ti equals to Mi plus Ai, where Ai stores a secret tag view, then we can transfer it into an equivalent statement by replacing the tag Ai to be its concrete view. And another issue that we concern about is the performance. We note that it is possible to make use of the bitwise operations to optimize our implementations. First, we can obtain a bit for free, unlike the C language that needs shifting and other logic operations. What can we do with this? For example, we can directly obtain the carry bit in big integer addition, which can be done by a single variable, and erase bits with free chip assignments, like this. We can also tailor the bit-wise move operations to move a bit to the target position with one assignment statement, like this. So that we can efficiently implement the basic functionalities, including shift, rotate, and permutation box.
Lastly, we can merge bitwise operations of a procedure, like permutation box, into other procedures, like substitution box, instead of executing these procedures independently. We apply this optimization in the implementation of present, that we can run the permutation box to each intermediate substitution result on the fly, rather than at the end of the substitution procedure, to avoid the steps for assembling the small intermediate substitution result to a large view, as in the implementation of present.
Now, I summarize the selection theory of cryptographic algorithms in PLCrypto as follows. Most of the snitted algorithms are standardized by either ISO or LIST, which are widely accepted in practice. We also try to seek algorithms that have good performance on PLC, such as subset sum based one-way function and spec. Specifically, algorithms that are easy to pre-compute their expensive operations could reduce the computation cost, such as Phaeton, which can pre-compute the S-box and P-box related operations. Relatively, the above bitwise optimization structures can optimize algorithms that comprise of many bitwise operations, such as permutation box. Lastly, we select algorithms with short case and parameters, SKP, since case and parameters should be hardcoded due to TMA. This criterion would also affect the size of the code. You can have a look at the corresponding selection criterion and the techniques that we use to implement the corresponding algorithms in PLCrypto.
Next, I'll show some examples of implementation. The first one is the subset sum based one-way function. Such one-way function has a parameter A, which consists of LN numbers, which is LN bit. On input of LN bit view X, the one-way function is computed based on following equation. Namely, each bit of X is used to determine whether the corresponding parameter small ai will be added. We first study the importance of hardcoding the parameters. The big A, consider the situation that one initialize the parameter A once with a separate initialization task, but use it repeatedly across executions, scan cycles. However, when such an initialization task is done, the network attackers are able to modify A to launch a tag manipulation attack to recover the image X. For example, to obtain J's bit X, the attacker only needs to set AJ to be non-zero and all other small X to be zero. It is obvious that the evaluation result of one-way function would be either AJ or zero. That could be used to infer XJ trivially. Since the LN is not small, we adopt the HCW to hardcode the call statement involving AIJ. Note that we cannot use the loop statement anymore due to the hardcoding of A. So we use Python to pre-generate those concrete hardcode statements, like the following figure. We use the similar idea to realize the shift and rotate functionalities. The left figure is the pseudocode for hardcoding, and the right figure is the resulting SQ codes.
In the implementation of Peasant, we combine the operations in Sbox and Pbox from the pseudocode of the Peasant. That we implemented base tags. We realize the Sbox and Pbox using single for instruction. Namely, we implement the Sbox and Pbox together for each nibble of a state rather than executing them one after another. You can see the hardcoding implementation of SP layer of present.
Finally, we show the benchmark results of our implementations. We use a commercial PLC from Alan Bradley to run the implemented algorithms. The performance of one-way function and block ciphers can be found in the following table. We can say that the performance of those algorithms on PLC is practical, and all operations only need a few milliseconds. In particular, the encryption of present is faster than Simon. That is contrary to the result on other platforms, since the implementation of present can be better optimized based on bitwise operations. The performance of TSK and the corresponding PRF, PRG are practical as well. However, the performance of these hash functions are not very good on PLC, since they require many arithmetic operations that are not very supported on PLC. This is our summary.
Thank you for listening.